Whoa. Okay. Now we are on level 4, the Sunken Palace, I believe this one is called. You can actually take your time in this water. There's no sharks in here, thankfully. I don't think there's much of anything else, unfortunately, like no med kits or ammo or anything like that. I'll swim around briefly to see, but I do not think there's anything here. This is just kind of the starting area for the underground palace that they've been digging out, I suppose. Under surface. Jesus. It's like, why the fuck did you almost try and kill me? So our objective, what we want to do is smash through... Ultimately, we want to... Oh god, what a terrible camera angle. Smash through that wall over there. And to do that, we need to have access to the crane... so we can pick up the head to smash it through the wall. But in order to get the grain, we are going to have to take down this pillar. Which needs a demo charge, which you can only find over here in this next section. So climb out here, because it's the only way to go. There's a med kit in here if you need it. I think I'm at full health. Yeah, okay. Well, it's there if you need it. And this next part does indeed have sharks in it, so be wary of that. Swim down through here. Have one come straight at your face. You're going to want to turn left immediately upon entering this area. The sharks, thankfully, are quite slow compared to the crocodiles, at least. And they're a lot slower than they were in... Okay, thank you for ruining my speech. I guess not. They are quite a bit slower than they are an infernal machine, so hopefully you shouldn't take too much damage from them. You might get unlucky like I did there, but it is what it is. There's a dude prowling around. I think I can fight this guy. Kindly remove you of your firearms, sir. I think he's the only one here, so he's a pretty easy fight. Ooh, look at these blocks. Look at these jukes. He heard he was an easy fight and never liked it. Some juking going on. I never use them. I know you can, but... I just never use them. Okay. Oh, right. So that oxygen tank I picked up there at the beginning of the level... What that does is it actually increases your air capacity underwater, obviously. So you can stay underwater for longer, which is going to be a real help in this level.
It's full.
And we get our spear gun, which is a lot of fun. So it's the only weapon other than the machete that can be used underwater. So it's very helpful. Here's the map that we were looking for. You also need to pick this up as well as part of your objectives. We're going to need this for the next level. Fuck your drinks. This is cheap, shitty wine. I don't know what they're drinking. It's like wine coolers. Disgusting. If you come back here, you kick these boxes down. There's a little hole here. And here's a fountain for you once again if you need it. Lots of hidden fountains in this chapter. There is a hidden artifact in this chapter as well, but it comes much later in the level, like right near the end. Okay, so now that we got all the stuff in here, you can get out your gun, and you can jump in here. You're going to see some divers guarding the demolition charges that we need. So it's time to take these dudes out. It's about 2 shots from the spear gun. Easy enough to do. I think you can carry 2 demo charges with you. But yeah, you can see on the side there how much higher oxygen tank is. There's some more ammunition down here if you need it. If you miss those guys, there's also... Oh god, am I stuck? Please god. Come on. Get me out of here. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, right for the surface. Good god, I thought I was dead there. I think that's all there is down here. I can take a quick look around, but I think that's pretty much it. What's this down here? Oh, there's a machete down here as well. You can take it if you want. I don't think you explicitly... Or wait, you do actually need it. No, you don't. You just need a knife for the final artifact. So the Turkish knife will be fine. But you can take it if you want. You can use it against sharks. Just remember to hit the secondary attack underwater, or else he's not going to swing it. Okay, so now we got our demolition charges. We can head back to where we need to be. And that's it. That's pretty much... This is a really short level. Be wary once again. The sharks are still here. I don't think there's anything in this section that you need to pick up, so you don't have to spend too much time in here. Where are they? Oh, Jesus. They're sitting right by the entrance? What a bunch of assholes. What a bunch of dickheads. That's some garbage. Okay. So climb out here, and now we have demolition charges to blast that pillar there for us. It feels good to be in non-shark infested waters. Those are dicks. They're just waiting right by the exit. What the fuck? Some smart sharks. Plant this, take a dive into the water. Get as far away as possible. I really don't trust these explosions. I really don't, because they are brutal. They hit you, like, from 100 feet away when you least expect it. And I don't want to deal with that. So now it's made us a bridge up to the next, or up to the upper levels here. There's a med kit there if you need it. Maybe I'll use it. Oh, you gotta get out of the water to use med kits, my bad. There we go. Thank you. For whatever reason, the machete doesn't want to be stowed with spacebar. I don't know why. Okay. There's a lot of swimming in this level, as you might expect, because it's an underwater kind of palace thing. Okay, so you want to climb your way up here using this pillar. Don't run off the edge. Jesus, I don't know how I didn't there. It's the tippy top of the top. Okay, you're going to want to drop down onto this platform here. Make this jump across. Thankfully, like, you're over water for the vast majority of these platforming segments. So even if you fall, you usually just have to climb back up again. It's not too bad. Okay, make your way over here. Jump across. Fuck. Okay, attempt number two. Gonna be one of those. Thankfully, it wasn't above a bottomless pit. I may actually die a lot on the next level. The next level sucks and is probably the worst level in the game up to this point. I just hope it doesn't fuck me over really bad, but I'll get to that when we get to the next level. Next. Oh, come on! I'm gonna have to speed this one up. Fuck me. I'm not lining up my jumps properly. I'm not taking my time. Nice, there we go. Jump across here. Jesus, I almost blew it again. Okay, let's make sure to line this up properly. There we go. There we go. That's a little bit better. There we go. Okay. Climb up on this little platform here. And I think that you just drop down. I haven't forgotten about the artifact. To get the artifact, you're going to want to use the whip right here. The icon doesn't come up, but you can whip this hook. And you're going to want to get to this box, chop it down. The machete or the Turkish knife work. And you get the Delian Proclamation, which is the third and final artifact of this chapter already. It's actually a fairly short chapter. It's not too bad. Climb up into the crane. Ugh, Jesus. But yeah, once again, if you forget to get the machete, the Turkish knife also works there. And we are going to want to pick up the head in the water. It's here, I think. He's lucky it fell with the ring facing upwards, or he would have been fucked. Just no splash effect whatsoever. Okay, and you just keep moving this to the right until it smashes the wall. There we go. Indy gives no fucks about destroying priceless treasures. That wall was probably 3,000 years old. Does he care? No. Okay, so now you can just exit out of here. I believe you can just take this platform around. Can you get by here? There we go. There's a little platform to fall on here. And then just take this up. This isn't quite the end of the level. You gotta do a little bit of climbing here, but simple enough. I'm gonna come to the back here, climb up these stairs. There's a post to whip here. Make our way across and finish one final jump. And that's the end of the level. We're done! Only three levels left to go, but this next one is awful! Oh god! Okay. So we'll see how this level goes. This level was an absolute bastard to me when I was doing my first run through. I died 6 times on this level, and all of them were complete bullshit, either by shark deaths or getting blown up. Really, they were all getting blown up, but some of them sharks were involved. So our object of this level is you make your way to the Temple of Poseidon, but you need to find the 4 coins before you make your way to the temple. And that's what this map is for. We are basically starting in that bottom kind of square there, right by the head, with that circle kind of in the middle. Oh, sorry, no. We are by the damaged wall, the X by the damaged wall. We came from that circle, and there's the crane there and everything. So I guess the Nazis wrote up this map, and they have found all the coins for us somehow, even though the walls aren't broken, which doesn't make a whole lot of sense. But so to begin, you're just going to want to jump into the water here. Once again, there's lots of sharks, so be aware. God, they're like guarding every single exit. Leave me alone, leave me alone. Did I lose him? I think I lost him. Good. And then climb out here. This is the only place to climb out for right now. Don't continue swimming. You can keep swimming on if you want, but you're not going to get anywhere. You're going to hit a wall and the sharks will eat you anyway. So climb up here, whip your way across, get up here and wall shimmy around the corner. This is another kind of platforming maze that you got to get through. Just drop off here, be very careful because you don't want to fall off, and jump to this next platform. Keep climbing up, cut across here. down this little walkway and up onto this next block. And then you're going to want to jump. Oh, shit. Ah, fuck. He didn't jump. Not great. He's always waiting. Always. Fuck these sharks, man. Bullshit. Okay, let's try that again. Get up there. Jesus Christ. If you find you're gonna fall in the water lots, it might be worth it just to shoot the shark with the harpoon gun. But I believe there are two sharks in this water, so you're gonna have to waste like six shots on them, which isn't ideal. Okay. Okay. Attempt number two. There we go. Jump across to this. And then to this one here. Perfect! And then you're going to want to come up here. It's going to be a dude over there. I usually just shoot this guy because trying to jump across a platform while there's a guy right there waiting for you is really shitty, and I don't really like it. It's just like a recipe to get kicked off the edge. There's going to be another two guys down here, but one guy's going to get crushed. This guy doesn't have any guns on him, so you can fight him if you want. I think the trick, the best... Okay, fine. The best trick with these guys with the knives is to just be super aggressive. Because you can't block the knives anyway, so just go in there fist flying. And we found the wine coin. This unfortunate soul got squished trying to get it out of there, I guess. It never really explains who those people are or why they're working with the Nazis in the first place. They're just kind of there, and I don't understand why. But anyway. So that's the first coin of the level. We need to collect three more. And you're really going to start to see why this level sucks, because there's no checkpoints. When you're on coin 4 and you die, you go right back to the start of the level. So you're going to want to swim up here. Come on. There you go. Weird, weird physics there. And swim up those stairs. That's going to take you to the upper part. If you try and swim underneath this structure, you're just going to hit a wall on all sides. So don't do it. There's some sharks down there looming, just waiting for my body. Whew, I thought they were going to get it there. I didn't think that I had jumped far enough. Don't jump and whip there. Just stand and whip, because it could toss you over the edge, which is a real pain in the ass. Okay. Climb up here. There's going to be some grenades for you. You can take them if you want. I already have full grenades anyway. They're, like I said, they're a really bad, like, it's almost like playing Russian roulette with them in this level. I'm not a huge fan of them because they have such a huge blast radius and there isn't a whole lot of places to go up here when you're on these platforms. You can jump into the water, I guess, but then you've kind of lost all your progress. So it's up to you if you want to use them, but it is kind of risky. So there's another two God, every time! They're just tracking me. Get up, get up! Oh, did I get lucky there. So climb onto this little platform here. This is where you want to go. We've already found the wine coin in that little offshoot there. So the trident coin and the seahorse coin are in this room here. And I will show you where to get them. So climb up onto these little platforms right here. And run down onto this one. You're going to want to jump across here. And there's some dudes down here. So this is your opportunity to maybe get out some explosives if you want. Keep in mind, though, that they can absolutely throw it back at you. Didn't want to do that, but I don't know if it actually killed anybody or not. They can pick up the grenades and throw them back in your face, though, which happened to me several times when I was playing through this the first time. I just kept getting killed by grenades every single time. They don't have grenades themselves, though, so if you don't use a grenade on them, they can't throw anything back at you, thankfully. Did I kill them? I can't tell. Did I get them? I think I did. Nice. Well, that worked. So we're gonna have a couple dynamite charges here.
It's full.
And we're gonna need both of them. Two of the three in this room, and then you'll use the third one in the next room. So pick up two of them for the time being. Come across this other way over the platforms. And make your jump across to this other pillar over here. Climb up on top of this. And then you're going to want to run down this Jesus. You're going to want to run down this pillar here. It's fairly thick, but, you know, just be careful. And this is where you're going to want to put your first demo charge. And once again, run as far away as possible because these things have a blast radius like crazy. But you can just also walk through the fire without taking any damage, so it doesn't really make sense. Another thing that doesn't make sense is how the Nazis would know the coin was here without busting open the walls, but I digress. So here's the Trident coin. We got that all done. And now to show you where the seahorse coin is. Oh, look at that dirty shit shark. So you're going to want to return to this small platform here. Where is that shark? So the seahorse coin is... Sorry. The seahorse coin, you need to blow open that wall there. But the problem is that a lot of the times when you place the charge, a shark will eat your face. Which doesn't kill you, but it means you can't get away from the explosion and you will die. So if you want to kill the shark beforehand, I would really advise you do it, because this is one section of this level where the shark can absolutely fuck you over super hard, and it is not fun for anybody. Where are you, you shit? Here he is. And just three shots takes him out, I believe. So now you don't have to worry about the dude ambushing you when you're trying to place a detonation there. So place your charge there, climb up here, and it'll blow up that section of the wall for you. Why there's fire underwater, I don't know. And here is the seahorse coin. So we only have one coin left. And we can move on to the next room. It's both coins in this room. And the fourth coin is in the last room of this level. And once again, we got all the artifacts for this chapter already. So although this level looks big, thankfully, like, there's no artifacts that you can miss here, which is nice. Oh, shit. Well, here you are. Where were you guys? I thought I blew you up with a grenade. Did that guy just suicide off the edge? You can join him. Oh, no, there he is. Join your friend. Just drown them both. So grab the last charge here and go through this entryway. We are now in kind of this room right in the middle of the map. There is where we're at now. Okay, so you're going to notice a cracked wall here. So this is a place for the final charge. It just leads you to a fountain. There's no need to open it. But, ooh, Jesus, I forgot there was a hole there. But you can if you want. If you're running low on health, you can fill up your canteen here. They hide all the fountains in this chapter. What a bunch of dicks. Some spear gun ammo. Jump up onto this rope. So this part is also pretty shitty. There's a couple more of the Arabian guys here. I guess they'd be Turkish. Or no, this would be after World War II, so it wouldn't be Turkey. Or yeah, I guess the Turkey still exists. But these guys also have grenades that they throw at you, or they can throw at you. So, I just kill them as fast as possible. Like, look at that. Look at how far that blast went. But I think I did kill them both. I absolutely did not. Hopefully he blows himself up with that one. He totally did. Like, look at that radius. I find that a little ridiculous, but when it works to your advantage, it's good, I guess. But yeah, this pathway in particular sucks. If you get into trouble and a grenade's about to go off and you got nowhere else to go, I would just jump into the water. Having to climb your way back up to this platform is much better than having to climb your way or having to start back at the beginning of the level. There's some more grenades there if you want them, but I don't really want them. And you just need to make one final jump onto that little outcropping right there. Nice. Perfect. And now we are on to the final room of the level. Which is this big room here. And before you jump up there, you're actually going to want to swim down here because the last coin, the Kraken coin, is located right at the bottom next to this fucking shark. I am not having any luck with the sharks today. Grab your hat, you dick. Is he not going to grab it because it's underwater? Really? Okay, well, whatever. It'll be back on your head in the next chapter. Shark, leave me the fuck alone. Go away! Go away! Okay. Where do I get out of here now? Step here? There we go. I guess he's just leaving his hat in the depths. I think we should have it next level anyway. Jesus. What a terrible ending for the hat, just left in the water at the bottom of some forgotten temple in Istanbul. Make for a good story, I guess. So here's kind of a really simple puzzle. You just look at the images, that's a woman pouring wine. So this means that it's the wine coin, not the canteen, you moron. You put that in the slot, and you just have to do that with all three of these. Poseidon is the Poseidon coin, or the Trident coin, sorry. Okay. I believe this is the Kraken coin here. Yep. Put that in its spot. And finally, the Seahorse coin. And if you do happen to miss any coins, you can get back to every part of the level from here. If you miss the wine coin, it might take you a while, but you can get back to everywhere. So just turn the switch, lowers the pillars, and opens the door for us. Okay, we're on to the second last level of the chapter already. Mm, which is The Fall of the Sea King, I believe this level is called. And this one's fairly short. The next two levels are both fairly short. I think that's actually the longest level in the chapter, the one we just did.
A few carefully placed charges should do the trick.
So our objective here is to topple the statue so he breaks the floor. You can't get through this way yet because there's water everywhere. This is a platform that leads to basically nowhere. It's how you get back up once you fall into the water. So for now we're going to go for a short swim between the dude's legs. Some divers with spear guns are going to show up. So it might be a nice time to take out the spear gun. Shoot those guys real quick. Grab their spear guns, and they also have some nice charges for us. So grab both of those. And you can put one already right on the dude's heel. Swim away, make sure you don't get attacked by the blast. So his one heal's good. So now you can swim down here into this little tunnel here. That's where you're supposed to go, kind of underneath everything. And you can climb out here. Up the stairs. And you're going to find yourself in the water, basically the dam room. And so if you want to shut off the water so we can whip across there, just turn this crank here. That's going to shut off the water that allows us to whip across that gap. But you're also going to get a couple of guys coming in ready to beat your ass. Just two of them. And I don't think they have knives either, so... should be hopefully an easy fight. Nice. Very easy. And I like that they included a little passage that these guys actually came out of. It's kind of a nice touch. I was expecting just to find a blank wall there, but they did actually come from somewhere. We just don't know where. Okay, so now we can just go back to where we were. Swim back out to the main room. Up to this platform here, and climb on top of it. And jump to that one. And now we are back up where we need to be. Now we can whip our way across. Floor is going to kind of break there, just be aware of that. You can still jump across it, just be prepared to jump. So I don't think there's anything over here for us. This is just an empty space. So what you're supposed to do is whip across Poseidon's trident here to get to the other side. There's another jump there. Ooh. So try not to fall in there. And this is going to give us access to his thigh or whatever. I suppose. Be kind of cautious about that drop because it isn't, oh god, please don't kill me. Ooh. I can hear him filling up in the background. Sounds like he's taking a pee. There's a fountain back here for you. It's the only fountain that's not hidden in the like entire game. So yeah, we've blown up his thigh and his ankle. So what that did is knocked this pillar down for us. So we can use it to access the other side of the platform right here. And climb up these vines. Like, the most coincidental vines ever. We haven't seen any kind of plants in this place the entire time we've been in here, except for the ones we need to actually get up on the upper levels. How lucky is that? And you're just going to want to whip your way across to his head. and hit him in the head. Knock him in the back of the head to open up this little hole here. And there we go. And now we're on to the boss fight of this chapter already. Last level. We've blown through it pretty quick. And this is actually a super simple boss fight, too. It's actually easier than the last one. So there's a reason that the Kraken coin was here, and that's because, I guess, the Kraken actually exists. And you have to take him out to get the third piece. So immediately climb up here, you're going to get the golden super spear gun, which allows you to carry 300 bolts, which is going to be needed to defeat the Kraken. Load up on 2 charges. There's also an oxygen tank for you if for whatever reason you missed it in the last level. Let's avoid those things. Or not. So these are like tentacles. They're going to pull you in. You basically have to press the fight key to get rid of them. Otherwise, they pull you toward the Kraken. You can also shoot them with the spear gun. So pop all those things with the spear gun, and then what you're supposed to do is shoot at the Kraken's eyeball. And then once you hit it, he's going to get wounded. He's going to slink back into his cave. And what you need to do is you need to plant charges around his pillars. If you get lucky, you can plant 2 charges before one goes off, which means you only have to do this twice. So come back up here, get 2 more charges. Jesus, get away from me, weird little pestilent balls. Look like funguses. Oh shit. Yeah, if you're having trouble targeting his eyeballs with the keyboard, I find using the mouse to aim in first person is a lot easier. There we go. And that should do it. Once you blow up all 4 pillars, it's the end of the boss. He goes back into the shadows. The waters recede. And that's the boss fight. She's a very simple one. Not very hard at all. Probably one of the easiest bosses in the game, actually. It just takes a little bit to maybe figure out what to do. So I'm just going to show you around a little bit now that the water's receded. I could have done this, I guess, while the water was still raised, but... So this is where we came in from. But there's actually, I believe, a little tunnel somewhere back here. There's a couple of spear bolts here for if you run out of ammunition. You also have a couple on the other side, I believe. You really shouldn't run out of ammunition. Like, I still have, what? Like, yeah, 500 left. And I don't think there's a max capacity to this thing. And those are bunches of 100, so, like, I don't know. Unless, like, you're really struggling with this boss, you shouldn't really need that many at all. There's also a couple down here as well. I don't think you can get in here until the Kraken goes... Sorry, not in there. I don't think you can get in here until the Kraken sinks back into kind of his lair. Because otherwise he's going to push you back. And there's a medkit back here if you need it. For whatever reason, I'm still full health. I never took any damage from that thing whatsoever. Some more spear bullets out here. So we've now got almost 800 shots, and you might use 100 of them, 200. And yeah, that's pretty much it. When you're ready to end the level, just walk up here and grab the third piece. You also can't get back here. I've tried jumping over the pillars to see if I could follow it, but you cannot. So yeah, pick up this third piece, and chapter 3 ends.
That was most impressive, Dr. Jones.
Damn right it was. Save I didn't even take any damage.
I got what you wanted. Now tell me what's really going on here. Why didn't you and Kai warn me about the Nazis?
Nazis.
The man you know as Marshal Kai is not who he appears to be. Kaidi Chan is not just an officer in the army, he's also the head of the Black Dragon Triad, the most powerful criminal syndicate in China.
What a double cross. That we never saw coming. Completely.
The heart of the dragon.
So I'm guessing you're not his secretary.
I'm working undercover for the Chinese government, monitoring the Black Dragon Triad. I hoped to sabotage Kai's hunt for the heart myself, but then your intrusion complicated matters.
How's that?
What are you?
Once you beat Fong back to the first piece of the mirror, Kai saw his opportunity to double-cross the Nazis and keep the heart for himself.
He's as mad as the Nazis.
Hmm.
That's why we must enter the tomb and remove the heart before Kai or the Nazis get there.
Why should I trust you?
First of all, I could have left you back there with the Nazis, and secondly...
Oh. The knee flexes. Indy has absolutely zero of them.
Good point.
Like the finger guns.
Please tell me you have a plan.
The finger guns right at her.
Ah! Waiting to take us to Hong Kong, where we'll meet a smuggler who will take us to Kai's fortress.
Sounds good to me. Let's go.
Let's get the hell out of here. Oh god, we got some watchers in the wings. And yeah, that's the third chapter of Indiana Jones and the Emperor's Tomb. We are off to Hong Kong for chapter 4. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It's a short but sweet chapter. And we'll see you next time. Take care. Bye.